Now for the great news. Hepatitis B has a vaccine. It's the only virus in the three main bloodborne pathogens that we're talking about where we have a vaccine available. Hepatitis A, remember, is a fecal-oral and not a bloodborne type virus. Now, we also have vaccines for hepatitis A, but specifically talking about bloodborne pathogens, hepatitis B is our only big hitter that has a vaccine. Now, here's how it works. Hepatitis B vaccine is to be administered over a 6-month period, and then what I encourage all of my students is to get a titer drawn to make sure your body seroconverted to that vaccination process. It is about 3 different vaccinations in that 6-month period, and unless your body seroconverts and shows a good number or an adequate number of antibodies, you don't have the protection that you need when it comes to secondary contact from hepatitis B. If your body doesn't seroconvert to that last vaccination, you fall into a small category of people that probably won't. It's now suggested that we do not give a 4th vaccine, though your practitioner may differ from that. It just goes to say, we're not going to rely on your vaccination anyway. We have other ways of protecting ourselves. We're not going to touch body fluid without personal protective equipment anyway. Who's to say that blood doesn't have HIV or hepatitis C in it? We don't know that. So we're going to use the same personal protective equipment anyway. But the hepatitis B vaccine is a great safety net to help keep us healthy in case a secondary contact that we weren't aware of does occur. Now, remember that the vaccine must be offered to all employees who either fit into a type A risk group employee role, which is an employee who will or may come in contact with blood or body fluid as it relates to their job description, even if that job description is voluntary. Now, OSHA and your local state OSHA regulations have a few clauses in there which can be a little tricky, like you don't have to necessarily, as an employer, offer the vaccine until your first exposure. A little bit of the tail wagging the dog, potentially, because we want to be vaccinated and have good antibodies prior to our exposure to that potentially infectious virus, to that virus at all. So, be sure you know what your regulations are. Make sure that you're taking advantage of your roles and responsibilities as a volunteer or a designated worker who comes into contact with blood or body fluid or potentially does. And make sure you protect yourself by knowing where your personal protective equipment is and making sure it's accessible, getting your vaccinations before you get an exposure, if at all possible, and then knowing what your policy and procedure is going to be telling you to do if you actually get an exposure incident.